Hello everybody and welcome back to Skyward Sword, and today we're going to be returning to the sky and then going to meet the old woman within the sacred temple. There'll be a lot of cuts in the first start of the video, so just bear with me while I speak and a zip around Skyloft. Okay, first thing is here in the bazaar. I want to actually show the upgrade system, because we have a damaged wooden shield which needs a bit of a repair. We almost lost our wooden shield in the Linera mines, so we're just going to upgrade it to actually fully heal it. We need one monster claw, one jelly blob, and two ember relics. We have multiple of everything of those that we need, so I'm just going to go ahead and upgrade it. So he'll turn around and he'll just go to work on it. And eventually, we get our upgraded shield. You can actually upgrade your shield for a third time, but we'll not go into that because I don't have the items. You can upgrade like all your equipment as well. But as you can see, we don't have the necessary materials. We're always missing one or the other. Branded shield, you know, you can upgrade it again, but we need more monster claws and tumbleweeds. Not really a point in it. We'll probably do this towards the end of the game. We just upgrade all of our stuff to the best. Okay, so there we go. So this is a Pivot's house. I think I've shown the inside of this place before. Now that we have the gust bellows, which is the little item that we picked up in the temple, we can clean this woman's house for her. So if we accept this quest, what the reward will be is 20 rupees plus 5 gratitude crystals. And it's the gratitude crystals that we're interested in, obviously. But the rupees is a nice addition to it also, but I've kind of preferred a heart piece, but whatever. If you just go ahead and like tape your spells and just like spray the floor, pretty much. There's the floor, the windows, I think there is the boots and everything too. Even around the bed, I'm pretty sure it was dusty. This woman just does not clean at all, it seems like. She just doesn't do anything. I mean, this is like worse than my room when I was in high school. Well, my room is not this bad, like, a state where there was dust everywhere, but I hardly ever had time to, like, clean my room in high school. I was overworked with, actual schoolwork and stuff like that. I mean, this is probably, like, 10 times worse than anything anybody can ever imagine, their room being, like, I'm sure I'm not the only one that's guilty of never having time to properly get around to quitting. You just kind of do the odd bit here and there, and the thing that gets in the way the most gets moved out of the way and all that kind of thing. But I like, unless I really have to, I don't really do a full clean. Unless it gets to the point where it just aggravates me that much, where I can't stand it anymore and I have to clean. Which, to be honest, I'm surprised this woman doesn't have, because I wouldn't be able to live in a house like this. This is absolutely disgusting. Could you imagine living in an environment full of cobwebs, dust, and everything? I mean, look how much better her house looks already. It's just ridiculous how disgusting her house was. I'm looking for that last bit of dirt. Like, Link's feet don't really change when you're on a carpet, so you can't tell when you're on top of it. Is it around her, maybe? I'm not sure. Nothing on the ceiling. Oh, there it is, right there. And once you're done, she'll prompt you with it. And basically go over and talk to her again. And she'll give us 20 rupees. And 5 gratitude crystals. I think the gratitude crystals come first. Yeah, they do. So this has got 23 gratitude crystals. And we get 20 rupees on top of our little collection there for our reward. Okay, so now after I'm done with this, I'm gonna go ahead and fly down to the forest to go meet the old woman. So I'll meet you when we reach that point. Okay, so just fly down to the portal that we've went down into before, well, the gap in the clouds, rather, that we've been through before. Okay, so now Gris is down here with us on the surface, and he's totally confused, but, well, he kind of understands now that, you know, there's actually a world down here, but imagine if he actually was the one to say Hyrule there instead of Grisland. That would be ridiculous.
key! No!
Well, you see, Grace, I'm Kennedy Hero. That must be a big blow to his ego right now. We actually haven't tried to play the harp yet, which is somewhat surprising because I thought that would be one of the first things I did, but she's going to teach us how to play it anyway, so there's not really much of a point. You have to keep in speed with the ball. Like the braid around her hair. And performed her first song, The Ballad of the Goddess. Okay, so we actually used the fairy the last time we were in the temple, so, well, in the Wanera. This is quite fortunate that they have one here. So now I can run outside to the front where Grissa left to, and we can find out what's going on. Okay, so if you just jump down here and use your sailcloth as you fall down to the middle, then you can make it all the way down here pretty quickly. The moment you get down here, you'll remember this thing which we struck before with the Skyward Strike is, well, activating. And here we go, it's the monster from our dreams. The Imprisoned. I wouldn't really call this a boss, but I guess we can classify it as a boss. We don't get a reward for it, other than progression in the game. Okay, so the objective, if you haven't figured it out already, attack its toes, and you can end up damaging it eventually, because taking out its toes is going to knock it over onto its stomach, and then, well, actually, it's going to knock it over onto its back, and then we're going to be able to attack it, and once that phase is done, it will go onto its stomach and move upwards towards the temple very quickly, and once it gets back on its feet again, we have to repeat the process until it dies, or, you know, gets resealed, as what we're attempting to do here. So just attack its toes, and falls onto its back, like so. Run around the back of it. One of his legs are normally up in the air, so you can just kind of run right around to its head. And if you do, like, downward strikes, you can, well, vertically attack it from bottom to top. You can knock it back into its fish-like skull. I honestly don't know what to call this thing. It reminds me more of a fish than anything else, the way it's shaped. So you can take one of these things up to a higher place. And as you can see, it's got back up onto its feet again, and it's bringing out the little thing that's keeping it imprisoned. And if you notice down there, he's kind of walking again, so he's slowly moving up here again. Just gonna grab a stamina fruit. This is why all these stamina fruits are kind of kicking around here. You can use them for this boss battle. And get this one too. Go around the back, attack this. Got a back tool, if you can even really call it. I don't know what to call it other than its heal, maybe? Part of its heel. Anyway, you can just do the process again, run underneath it, or run around it, and attack it, like so, and it'll get up again and move. Take this one. I think this one actually put me way too high. You can see it from here. Oh, maybe not, he's kind of catching up with me. Maybe after I run him, or even go above him. Alright, where is he? Oh, he's behind me. Yeah, so he'll bring out the seal again, and you can just wait until his toes reappear, and then attack his toes again. There we go, he regrew his toes. Just be aware that every time he takes a step now, it's going to be electrified. So, or at least this crab's gonna come out of his back of the feet and, like, This is gonna hurt you if you get the radius of it, so just be careful. Okay, that's the back done. We just need to get back to the front and take out the front toe. Okay, that's 1 foot down, which means that that foot won't produce any electricity coming off of it. So when we're near it, we're safe. But this one, however, definitely still is producing the shockwave around it. And it's still very much a threat, so... One more toe. And then it'll fall onto its back for the final time, and we're gonna strike the seal back into it again. I don't think the battle restarts if you don't do the Skyward Strike in time, but just in case, make your way down here pretty quickly and perform the Skyward Strike on it. You actually need to do this with a remote. You need to make the slices in such a direction that will make the seal. Mm-hmm. Actually, we feel really bad for Groot. You know, but, he's somewhat acknowledged for Link actually is the hero now after seeing him fate. And he's just, he's kind of beating himself up over the fact that he can't really help us. I mean, it's somewhat apparent that he's always been jealous of Link, but this must be, like, the most devastating thing that can probably happen to the guy. The fact that Link is the hero, the one who's meant to save Zelda, and the fact that, you know, he can't really do anything. He's beating himself up, fight. He can't even do anything, like, to help at all. I mean, it sucks, like, he's living in the shadow of Link, and he kinda always has been. He's probably just become to realize this, and that Link isn't a shrimp that he's been claiming. Link is actually the hero. I feel kinda bad for Groot, because he's obviously trying to be living outside of that shadow for such a long time. To keep the shadow away from him, that is, and stand out in the light. Yes, yeah, so this is what happens when your batteries begin to run out. File tell you that for kind of deplete. Well, you can do this, and pull out your harp, and just play a bit. And the Sheikah Stone will appear. It'll also give you something after this dialogue box is gone. It'll give you a spoil of some sort. So we got an ornamental skull from it. And you can use it as Sheikah Stone to, you know, get tips and whatever, just like the one in Skyloft. But I don't really want to use one, to be honest. Okay, so we're just going to save the game, and thanks for watching, and see you guys next time.